All right, let's say amen for Sister Ken.
I just want to thank God for what he's doing. And you guys know me. I have never, ever, ever, ever got up and did tell you about the importance of the word. And getting the word in you. And you know, the year just begun. You know, people make resolutions. You know, but we make commitments, not resolutions. Praise God. And several years ago, Pastor Hill encouraged us to make a commitment to the word, to reading the Bible through it a year. And that year, I read the Bible through the year, and my life has not been the same. And I made a commitment that I wouldn't let another year pass by without getting through the word and all. And this year, as I started to read the word, I talked to the Lord, and I said, Lord, now, I'm reading this word there, but I don't want to read it with just my mind. I need you to reveal your word, and I know your word is true, and I need it to be alive in me, and I need you to give me what I need from your word. And so I went into it, I started reading the word, and of course, it's amazing because when you start reading, it's almost like it's the first time you ever read. You know, you look at it, the pages open up and get excited about the word and all. And you know, the really important thing of what I really like about the word, you know, like the sister was saying, that God is the King of glory. You won't know he's the King of glory until you know what he's done. Praise God. And sometimes we tend to, as things start happening in our lives, forget what he's done for us and all. But it's written in the word what he's done and the great things that he's done in the word, and it's just amazing that how that builds your faith and lets you know when you're supposed to do those hard things and those hard times that you've got a God that is the King of glory. Praise God. And that he is wanting to do these things for you, and that he's willing to do these things for you. And with Pastor Hill, usually I'm back there with the kids, and sometimes we got the little speakers back there, but can't always hear. But the times that I get out here to do it, it's amazing how God is doing my heart. The same thing he's told Pastor Hill. I came out here yesterday, and Pastor Hill was saying that, you know, he's gotten to the time where he's just getting to where he knows that the God that he serves is going to do it for him. That he knows who he serves and stuff like that. That's what's coming up in my life. You know, I have the advantage most people don't have. I work a split shift. And I've got 4 hours in the middle of the day that can just be mine. I walk and I talk to God. Praise God. But it's amazing. God has been in those walks. He's been bringing over and over and over again. He is in me. And he is with me. And the word says that he is light. And where there is light, there is no darkness at all. You know, some hard things have come up, some situations that we look at in the natural and forget, we don't know what we're going to do about these things. But God just keeps quickening in me that he is light, and where there's light, there is no darkness at all. And the works of darkness have no effect on me. It can't even abide here because light is here. And you know, in my old age, I've gotten where I don't like the dark. You know, it used to be when I was young, I'd get around the house in the dark and just get around. It was like anything, but it's almost like I'm paralyzed in the dark. But one thing I found that as soon as I turn the light on, praise God, that the darkness is gone. And there's no fear. Praise God. And that's what happens. The word is that light in us. And when we allow that word to get into us, and all we have to do is just turn the light on. All we have to do is say the word. But you have to know the word, to say the word. And so I'm just wanting to encourage you to turn the light on. Darkness does not have dominion over you, but if you don't know it though, you'll be stumbling around and scared. Praise God. Turn the light on. Praise God.